was the most scariest part of my life. Never know what's gonna happen with you inside prison. You only hear about what other people say when you go inside prison. And you will be a prison wife, you will be raped. I'm staying in Paul. The area is called Chicago.
Stellenbosch, Paul, Worcester are the third, fourth oldest towns in South Africa. It just takes you back. You walk back into time, and you see the legacy of colonialism, of slavery.
This is the prison that I spent 3 years, 8 months on waiting trial. The day afterwards, while the wardens were unlocked us and count us and stuff like that, I asked him if I can see the sister. So when I went to her and tell her what has happened, that she must help me, she rather tell me that I must go and wash my stinking body.
Just like in the community, sexual abuse is not taken seriously. Many people in the community who report sexual abuse are often dismissed, blamed, asked many questions. What were you wearing? Where were you? What time was it? Really, really blaming the victim. And the same applies in prisons, hey? In that survivors are dismissed.
What we see happening in prison is actually, you know, the same stuff that sees women and children and men abused in our communities. Very toxic forms of masculinity. And if we don't address sexual violence, we're actually contributing to violence in our broader society.
Isaac is one of the survivors we work with, survivors of sexual violence. And he's one of the few very brave and incredible men who have spoken out about the problem of sexual violence in place of detention.
Go into prison with scars, come out of prison with a lifetime of scars. And that time I have many questions and I'm blaming myself of what had happened with me. And it was always the word if I didn't do that, if I didn't allow that. All those questions were running through my mind and I blame myself. And JDI have helped me to realize and to come to the conclusion that it just wasn't me, it isn't my fault.
When a government takes away someone's liberty, it takes on an absolute responsibility to take care of that person and keep them safe. And that really, it doesn't matter what crime someone may have committed, rape is not part of the penalty.
I just want to tell you who will ask me, why does I share my story? Not only for me, it's for those that are inside prison who stand up for their rights. I'm going to look into the future. I've been carrying for so many years this mask, the mask of getting polio, the mask of being inside prison, the mask of being raped, contracting the HIV virus. But I'm taking this off, that they can see the real identity, the real me.